Video editing is an art form. I love doing it, but it's something that you only learn by doing it over and over and practicing, and sometimes it can be a bit overwhelming. But there are a few easy ways to make simple video clips look super slick and on brand. Today I'm going to show you how to elevate simple video clips to make them look super professional just using animated graphics in Canva. We're going to start with a simple video file in Canva. This one is a horizontal format. You can, of course, do the same thing on a vertical format video. I'm just doing it this way because it gives me a bit more screen space to show you what I'm actually doing. First thing we need to do is just to insert the video that we're going to use for this example. I'm going to go to my uploads folder, and there is a roughly 30-second video that I recorded earlier to use for this project. I'm going to click on it, and it appears on my page. Then I'm just going to resize it to fill that page for the full 1080 video size. When I hit play, the first thing I notice is that there are a few seconds at the beginning before I actually start talking. And so I want to edit those out. So I'm just going to move my playhead so that it's just before I say the first word. And then I'm going to click and drag the left-hand side, drag that handle in to snap to the playhead. And now if I go to the beginning and hit play, I start talking right away. One easy way to make your videos look a little more professional is to include a top and tail. Now, a top and tail is just a screen at the beginning and at the end of your main content that frames the content. With something like a talking head video like this, at the beginning, you would probably have something that has a title on or introduces what you're going to be talking about. And at the end, I like to include something that has a bit of branding, but more importantly, lets people know what action you want them to take or how they can support or follow you. So we're going to create those in Canva. Now, you could create these from scratch, and we're just going to click to add two pages, first of all, to our project. And I'm going to click and drag one to before my video clip and leave one after. Now, depending on your brand style and how comfortable you are with your brand elements, or if you've got existing designs and templates that you can draw on, you could do whatever you want for this top and tail and make it as colorful or as bright or as perfect for your brand as you want. And you can do that just using simple elements in Canva. But we're actually going to use an existing template from Canva's template library. So I'm going to go over to Designs in the left-hand panel, and you can see that there is a whole range of designs you can choose from. Again, depending on what your brand is like, you could choose any of these that feel close to your brand and that are easy for you to customize. I'm just going to use this one at the top that says Digital Marketing Tools. And when I click on it, it's just going to insert that first slide into the blank slide that my cursor was on. Next, we're going to customize this so it fits with my brand. So the first thing I'm going to do is to just remove this quarter circle frame. And then I'm going to move the frame with a photograph up. And I'm going to adjust the sizing and location of this circle. And actually, I'm going to duplicate it and add a smaller one. And then I'm going to recolor them so that they fit for my brand. To recolor this whole slide, I could go to the brand icon on the left-hand side and then use my primary palette. And just by clicking shuffle, it will start applying my brand colors until there is something that I find easy to use or easy to customize. So for this one, I'm just going to change the colors on some of these circles so that they match my brand. And then for that image, I'm going to go to my brand folder that I've created, and I'm going to click and drag a photograph of myself into that frame. Next, we're going to customize the text. I'm going to click on this title, and the first thing I'm going to do is to change the font to the font that I want to use called Poppins, which is a really nice bold font, and I know it works well for titles. The subtitle I am also going to change to Poppins, to just the regular weight. I'm going to make that a little larger. Then I'm going to just reposition these and add my content in. Then I'm going to just resize them so that I think it all works nicely and add in a little bit of branding. So that's at the beginning as well. Now, because we used an existing template, there are already animations applied to these elements, but you could change them to whatever works for you or just find one that already has animations that you like and that's easy for you to use. So if I just play through this 5-second clip, you'll see the branding I put on and haven't added an animation to, but the rest of it animates really nicely. It's very subtle and I'm happy with that. What I am going to do is make it a little bit shorter. So once everything has animated in, I'm just going to give it a second or two, and then I'm going to click and drag this right hand handle till it snaps to where the playhead is. So it's now only 3.3 seconds before it goes into the main content. Speaking of which, to move from our first slide, this intro slide, into the main video clip, I'm going to click between the two elements and I'm going to add a transition, and I'm just going to use a simple dissolve. I'm going to take it down to 0.3 seconds, so it's fairly quick, but it just means that from that intro slide, we go straight into the content with me talking. And that looks really slick, but it's very subtle and it doesn't detract from the content. For the final slide, I'm going to create this one myself. So I'm going to use the brand charcoal color for the background. I'm going to add in a brand logo, and I'm going to add an animation to that. And for that, I'm going to add in this new animation called Succession, which has a kind of a blur and a zoom as part of that animation. Now, if you're looking for this animation and it hasn't appeared in your Canva toolkit yet, don't worry about it. I know that Canva is rolling this out, so it might take a little time to get to everywhere in the world, but it is coming, so keep an eye out for it. And if not, you can always reach out to Canva and ask them when it'll be available in your region. Next, I'm going to add a line by hitting L on my keyboard, and I'm then going to rotate it and put it in the center of the page so that it almost forms a center divider between the left and right of this page. Then I'm going to add in a text box, type in my URL or my website address, resize it, and put it on the right-hand side. For this line, I'm going to click on Animate, and I'm probably just going to choose the wipe animation, but I'm going to go so that it goes from top to bottom. And then for the website address on the right-hand side, I'm going to use that same succession animation that I used on the actual logo. And so when we now play that back, it goes from the content to that, and the logo, the line, and that domain name or website address appears. Now, I've kept this really simple, but obviously you can add in whatever you want. You could add in your social links, you could add in links to where your freebie or your lead magnet is, or anything else that will help people know how to take action, how to reach you or follow you or support you. So it's always good to have those on the end of the videos. I'm going to leave that at 5 seconds because people will click off the video when they're ready anyway. And then, of course, I'm just going to apply that transition between those two elements again. A dissolve at 0.3 seconds. And so that just means that at the end of the video, when I finish talking, it fades into that final slide. The next thing we're going to create is called a lower thirds. And all this means is that it's usually a text element that appears on videos to either show the person's name and title, or maybe give some context or tell people what they're talking about. And it appears for a few seconds, usually in the lower third of the screen so that it doesn't obstruct the content. And we're going to create that with our name and title just using Canva elements. So I'm going to go back to my video, and the first thing I'm going to do is to hit C to add a circle. I'm going to change that to my brand color, the charcoal color, and I'm just going to reposition that on the page and make it smaller. The next thing I want to do is to add my logo in because that's going to go over that circle, and I will add it there and align it with the circle. And then both of those elements I'm going to animate again, just using that succession animation so that it's consistent with the animations I've used elsewhere in this video. Before I add my next element, I want to make sure that these only come in a few seconds after the video has started. So if my video comes in and the content starts playing, I don't want that to come in immediately. I want it to come in around here. So I'm looking at about 7 seconds. So I'm going to click on those elements, and I'm going to click on the three dots or right click and choose show timing. And then I can click and drag the left-hand side so that that's where they start. If I drag the playhead, you'll see that we have a few seconds of me talking, and then they appear. Next thing I'm going to do is to add a rectangle, and I'm going to resize and recolor this to fit with my brand colors. I'm also going to round the corners so it creates this almost pill shape, and I'm going to move that down so that it's aligned with the circle, but I am going to use the layers tool to move it behind the circle and the logo. This box, which is going to contain the text boxes, I want to look as if it kind of emerges from behind that circle, which means that the animation I'm going to use is click on Animate and use Baseline, and then choose the arrow that shows it coming from left to right. Then I want to adjust the timing, and by clicking and dragging this, I can see once the circle and the logo appear, that's when the box should come in. Now if I click and drag the playhead and then just play it, you'll see the circle and logo come in, and then the box emerges from it. Next, I'm going to add in my text box. First of all, just my name and pronouns, and then format that again using Poppins to make sure that we keep things consistent. And I'm going to enlarge it and then just position it where I want it on that box. Next, I'm going to add in a second box, and I'm going to add my title in. Move that down and reformat again, just using Poppins. And then I'm going to just change the spacing of elements so that they all look consistent and they all work. Now, the text boxes, I definitely want to animate in the same way as that box that surrounds them, but I want them to come in a couple of seconds after. So I'm going to right click, having selected both of them, make sure show timing is selected, and then I'm going to click the handle on the left hand side and drag until we see the box has almost fully appeared, and then I can start those text boxes. And for the text boxes, I'm going to add the same animation with a baseline from left to right, and I'm going to slow that down a little bit so that we have slightly different speeds on the box and the text. In fact, to add some interest, I'm going to click on the subtitle of this text, which has my title in, and I'm going to choose that coming in from right to left the other way. And that's just to add a little bit of interest, and it looks kind of slick coming in from the right-hand side. Once that's been on for a few seconds, we then want it to disappear. So we're going to select all of those elements that we've just animated, and we're then going to click on Show Timing, make sure that it's visible, and we're then going to click from the right-hand side for all of those elements so that they disappear a few seconds after, and people just have enough time to read them, but they don't interfere with the actual content of the video. Now, when that disappeared, you'll see that the box behind the text actually moves off to the right, and I want it to go back to the left. And the way that I do that is by clicking on it, checking my baseline animations, and then at the bottom here, I will choose reverse exit animation, which means it comes on left to right, but it disappears right to left. And that just gives this really nice effect of it disappearing behind the circle again. So it's a subtle thing, but it does look a little more professional when things like that are paid attention to. Now that's a pretty simple lower thirds just created from individual boxes and elements in Canva. And obviously you could do the same thing if you wanted to highlight certain points in your content. For example, if you were talking about facts and figures and you wanted to show some statistics, you could just use Canva text boxes with those figures in and have them subtly animating in as you talk about them in your video. It's really easy to add those kind of graphics into Canva, and you can decide how long they're on the screen, you can animate them on and off, and it just adds a bit of punch to what you're talking about. Plus, of course, it keeps people's attention because there are different elements moving and changing. Another way to keep people's attention is by having things change in the video. So for example, you could change the framing of your actual talking head video. Now by that, I just mean that you'll zoom in or out. It keeps people's attention because something has changed. Now an easy way to do that is to create what's called a jump cut. Now a jump cut literally just means that you jump from one framing of a video to another framing of a video. There's no animation between them, and it's a very sharp cut. Now in Canva, this couldn't be easier to do, and I'll show you exactly how we do it using this clip. So I'm going to just play through and see where there is a bit of a natural pause when I'm talking. Once I've found that position, I'm going to leave the playhead where it is, right click on it, and I'm going to choose Split Page. Now all that means is that it split this video into two parts, but when you play it back, you won't see that there is a split there at the moment. But what we are going to do is we're going to change the framing of this second clip just for a few seconds, and then we're going to go back to the framing of the first clip. And we're going to do that by again choosing to right click on that area, choose split page, and now we essentially have three clips. The wide angle, we're going to have a closer angle, and then the wide angle again. And to get that close angle, we're going to just click and drag on this element on this video and enlarge it. Here's the trick, and this was something that a professional video editor taught me years ago. If you're going to do a jump cut, particularly on a talking head video, the best thing to do to make it feel natural is to make sure that the eye line is aligned between the two clips. Because people tend to look at someone's eyes when they're talking. If you keep them in a consistent location in the video, it's easier to do a jump cut that feels natural and doesn't feel disjointed. So we're going to do that in Canva by using guides. I'm going to just click on the ruler here, and I'm going to drag a guide down so that it crosses where my eyes essentially are in that frame horizontally. Next, I'm going to do the same with a vertical guide to the middle of my nose. And so now that means that you'll see when I play through, if I click on the guides, it's roughly where my eyes are. For the jump cut, we're going to go to that middle piece that we isolated. I'm going to zoom out on this page so that it's easier to click and drag and resize this. And then I'm just going to resize a little bit. There's no specific measurement here for this. Try not to make it too extreme. And then I'm going to click and drag it to make sure that, again, those lines show me where my eye line are, and I've got those guides. And now it means that we go from this wider shot to a slightly closer shot and back to a wider shot using a jump cut. Now you can put an animation between these, but sometimes with Canva those animations will cause the frames to blur a little as the animation is happening. But a jump cut can work just as effectively, and as I say, it's very good at capturing people's attention. The last thing I want to do is to add in a couple of sound effects, so I'm just going to click and drag my cursor to where those animations come in for the lower thirds, and just where they start animating, I want to add in a sound effect. And I'm going to go to apps, going to go to audio, and I'm going to type in transition, and I'm going to click and drag this first one in to where that cursor is. And that just means that as those animations happen, there is this subtle animation of movement, of a whoosh transition, and it just again attracts attention, and it adds a little bit of a more professional feel to your videos than just silent graphics all the time. Before we look at the finished video, if you found this helpful and you'd like to learn more about how to use Canva to its full potential, then there are two ways that I can help. The first is, I would love it if you would sign up to my weekly newsletter. It's called Meaningful Creations, and every week it shares free resources, new tutorials, creator profiles, and you can sign up in the link that's in the description below the video. Secondly, my Canva course called Canva OS will be open again for enrollment soon. So if you go to the link that's in the description or just hit on the link up here, you can sign up to the waiting list and I'll let you know as soon as that's open for enrollment. Now, let's have a look at what this video looks like with our graphics, with our top and tail, and see how much more professional it looks than just a simple video clip with no additions. When I started my YouTube channel, there were two things I was really clear about. The first was that I wanted to make sure I was helping people by making really good design accessible to everyone. And the second was that I was doing that by being myself, being authentically me, and never putting on any kind of pretense or false persona. And that means that sometimes I'm vulnerable, I'm very open about who I am and my life, but it also means that I connect with people in a way that is really real for me. That's it from me, folks. Stay awesome, keep creating, and have a fabulous week.